The professional peloton has had its fair share of beautiful and downright ugly cycling jerseys over the years. Today, we will be honoring some of these crimes against fashion in our list of the top 10 worst pro cycling kits. Number 10. Futon Servetto Fuji. The 2010 iteration of this team will not be remembered for its results on the road, but instead their cream-colored kit that did not win them many fans. The team that included the future Tour of Oman winner Rafael Valls and Vuelta points classification champion Fabio Fellini opted for the cappuccino-colored jersey, which was made only more bitter with the Big Foot logo placed on the chest of this kit. Not a good choice if you ask me. On the upside, however, it's no problem if you stay in your jersey on the cafe ride with a latte or flat white. Number 9. Tinkoff. The old school Tinkoff squad, yes, the same Tinkoff that bought out Saxo Bank, certainly had one of the most eye-catching kits in the bunch. This Russian formation opted for a yellow and black livery this year, and maybe it was in vogue at the time, but this melange of colours has not dated well. Don't expect to see this jersey at London Fashion Week anytime soon, or Oleg Tinkoff for that matter. Number 8. Bardiani. Get the eyewash out for this one. This Bardiani kit from 2020 is something to behold. No, not for its style and chic, but for the monstrous use of purple. The colour purple hasn't been used all that much in pro cycling kits, and that's for a good reason. This purple and green kit looks something like you'd wear to a 1970s disco, not the start line of a Giro d'Italia, that's for sure. Luckily, the time that this jersey spent on the podium was limited, as the kit didn't bring all that much success. Bardiani only took one win in 2020, and I personally put it down to the kit. Nevertheless, the old green and orange Bardiani kit is deeply missed. Number 7. Neri Sottoli. I think I need sunglasses to see this fluorescent kit. Neri has always prided itself in its eye-catching jersey designs, but their kits in the early 2010s brought this to a new level. This team did see success courtesy of the GC Hope and convicted doper Mauro Santambrogio, who took a stage in this heliograph of a kit back in 2013. The bright yellow would return, courtesy of our old friend Oleg Tinkoff in 2015 and 16, but this eyesore of a kit has received a redesign over the years, making it a lot less harsh on the eyes. Number 6. Castorama. Are these handymen or professional cyclists? Team Castorama blurred these lines with their blue-collared kit in the early 1990s. The hardware store decided to take an approach to show their stars such as Laurent Jalabert and Jacques Durand as builders or plumbers instead of a chic design. The French kit was paired, however, with a stripy undershirt. Although they tried to do something different, this trend didn't stick around for long. However, I must point out the similarities between this kit and the 2020 De Koenig Quickstep outfit. If you see it as well, please tell me in the comment section down below. Number 5. The Sayeco Muscle Kit. The last thing you want to see on a professional cyclist are their muscles. No, I'm not talking about their huge thighs, I'm talking about the pure flesh of their quads. While sprinting legend Mario Cipollini treated us all to this special exclusive skin suit at the Giro d'Italia. The Italian had quite the reputation of using unique designs for his time-trial skin suits, including a zebra, tiger, and a futuristic print. However, the muscle skin suit is easily the least forgiving on the eyes. If it's any consolation, the kit sold for $40,000 at a charity auction. Despite this, the infamous muscle suit reminds me more of the Bodyworks Science Exhibition. Google it for some reference. Number 4. Team Rock Racing. This rebellious team made headlines for its performance-enhancing drugs, but they will be etched in the minds of many cycling fans for its calamity of a kit. This jersey is cluttered in white and red graffiti spanning across the jersey and the shorts, but it's an absolute mess. Rather unflatteringly as well, the word dead is printed on a less favorable part of the body. A brave choice, if you want to put it that way. Number 3. Bogota Humana. In 2014, the Bogota Humana team became a viral story after the team presentation photo was taken at the Tour of Tuscany. This picture showed the six women wearing a red and yellow kit with a flesh-covered material immediately above and below the waistline. After the pictures went viral on social media, the UCI president at the time, Brian Cookson, tweeted, quote, "To the many who have raised the issue of a certain women's team kit, we are on the case. It is unacceptable by any standards of decency," end quote. Number 2. Ag2r Citroën. I'm sure this will go down in history as being the first jersey made on Microsoft Word. The big text and white space may satisfy some minimalists, but this jersey looks more like something from the bargain bucket than that of a professional designer. There was much hope that the iconic yet controversial brown shorts would say their farewell when the team received a cash injection from Citroën, but need not worry, this fashion abomination is staying for 2021. What frustrates me though is the nauseating pairing of red and brown on this jersey. I'm no Jean-Paul Gaultier, but these colours are far from complimentary. Now's the time you've all been waiting for though. What will be our number one pick? And we couldn't forget about this one, so at number one, we have the Palace Education First Giro d'Italia kit. 2020 was a bizarre year, but nothing was more bizarre than EF's new kit for the 2020 Giro d'Italia. Partnering up with streetwear label Palace exclusively for the Tour of Italy, the kit caught headlines and media attention across the world. The jersey became a key focus in the time trial when the kit was paired with a duck helmet, and it did look pretty sharp, I must say. Although some skateboarding fans were very much on board with the design, the cycling world never really warmed to this kit. However, the exclusive jerseys were sold on eBay after a small stock of jerseys were put on the market during the Giro. With the price tag hitting around about $1,000, this kit may be on the top of our list, but it is certainly one of the most lucrative. Nevertheless, tell us down in the comment section below what you think. Is the EF kit really that awful, or have we missed another ugly jersey from our list? Anyway, that's everything. Thank you for watching. We wish you a very good day, and we hope to see you again soon.